Hello, Klaus here, and welcome back to yet another video here at the channel. In today's video, we're going to talk about an issue with the Blackmagic Cinema Camera 6K full frame, and that is the issue with the rolling shutter. The rolling shutter on that camera is especially very bad compared to the 4K version or other of the versions. And as you've been seeing on some of my late videos, I did do a lot of tests and comparing these two things together with the rolling shutter. How good is it? How bad is it? All of that. And I had a lot of comments, people telling me that it was really bad, the rolling shutter, and I do know that. However, there is a fix for that as well. And I didn't really do a video about how to fix that issue, so in this video I'll show you how to use the gyro data to get rid of rolling shutter, or at least make it better using the 6K full frame cinema camera. So without further ado, let's just jump right into the video.
Okay, so here we are in DaVinci Resolve, and I'll show you how to fix this rolling shutter issue using the gyro data. I did do a lot of videos about the gyro data, by the way. So if you are interested in that, take a look at this video right up here. So in this video, I'll just show you how to correct the rolling shutter. And there are actually two ways you can do that in DaVinci Resolve. Either you can do this in the edit page, or you can do it in the color page. And I'll show you both ways. So first off, let's have a look at this clip here with the rolling shutter. And as you can see on the trees here, this is really, really bad. And this is shot on the 6K full frame in open gate, because in the open gate option, that is where the rolling shutter is the worst. So let's see if we can correct that. And it's super easy to correct, by the way. Let's just go to the stabilizations. And in the strength, we're going to put this all the way down to zero. Like so, and then we are going to change this into camera gyro, and we are simply just going to say stabilize. There we go. So here we can have a look at how that looks now. Compared to the shot we had before, this is really corrected a lot. I can just toggle off the stabilization. So you can see again up in the trees how they are waving or swaying around compared to when we use it here. Okay, that was the first way of fixing it. For the next way, let's go into the color page. And we are going to use it on this clip here, which is more like a handheld, fast-paced shot, which has a lot of rolling shutter here in the, you can see it here, like that. Okay, so the way we are going to correct that would be to go into the tracking, and we're just going to go up here and change this into stabilization, and we want to change it from perspective into camera gyro, and the strength we are going to change that into zero again, like so, and then we're just going to hit stabilize. Okay, so let's have a look at how that looks. And actually, if we push the zoom, we can actually see how much it's doing. So let's go back just a little bit here. You can see here, if we take a look at the black bars here, how much it's actually correcting when we push the zoom here. So we are cropping a little bit in the image to make it look better, but I think that is a pretty little price to pay to get rid of the rolling shutter. So anyway, this was just a super quick video on how to fix the rolling shutter using DaVinci Resolve and the gyro data if you're using one of the Blackmagic cameras that uses the gyro data, and that more or less is all of them by now. Anyway, I do hope you found this little video useful. If you did, please hit that subscriber button, give the video a like, share it with your friends if you think it would help them out, and if you want to be notified every time there's a new video on this channel, please hit that bell icon down in the corner. Until next time, keep filming, keep learning, and keep sharing.